Hello everyone, welcome to the software engineering course at AUL. So this is the first lecture. As usual, I'm going to introduce the course, give an overview about it, and talk about the details of the course syllabus, what you can expect from the course, what are the material of the course, and I'm going to briefly introduce the course in this first lecture. I'm going to divide the contents of each lecture to several videos to facilitate the process of uploading and downloading the videos. So you will notice that at the end of each section I'm going to finish the video and the next section will start in another video. Okay, first with respect to the course in general, the textbook of the course is the System Analysis and Design book, the 8th edition of it. I have uploaded this textbook to Google Classroom. Since you are watching this video, you should have already registered on Google Classroom, and you are able to download all the material of the course from Classroom. So this is the book, the textbook that we are going to use in the course. It is very important for you to download the textbook and keep it. And whenever you have any anything that concerns you or you don't understand very well in the lecture slides that I'm going to upload, you can refer to the textbook in order to get more information and to clarify any issue that at which you are stuck. Going back to the syllabus. As you can see, there are two courses that are prerequisite to the course, which are P2 and database. You should have taken them before the course. It's very important for you to understand general programming concepts, object-oriented programming, because we are going to tackle and use many concepts related to object-oriented programming in the course. Also, database is very important. We are going also to take in the course some sections related to the design of the database. So in general, the software engineering course is related to how to design a software. We are going to take material related to what are the design models of a software. There are several models that I'm going to talk about at the beginning and in the introduction, and then we are going to talk about each model alone separately in a single chapter. These models are the Software Development Lifecycle, SDLC, the Agile model, and the Object-Oriented using UML model. So these are the three models that we are going to take during the course. With respect to the contents of the course, how the content will be divided, as usual, there will be a midterm and a final. There are assignments and there is a project. With respect to the assignments, I will be putting them for you on Google Classroom. So each time we finish an important chapter in which we want to solve exercises, I will put an assignment for you on Google Classroom. Also, the course contains a comprehensive project that will enable you to implement what you are going to learn in the course. As usual in my courses, I'm going to upload a project manual for you, usually by the time of the midterm or after the midterm, in which you are required to select a certain topic from the project manual. You implement the topic, you design the software, and you provide at the end a report that contains a full design implementation of the required software. The details will be provided for you later. So this is how we are going to divide the assessment of the course. This semester we might not have attendance due to the current situation. So we might divide the attendance grade on other parts of the assessment. These are the learning outcomes of the course. You can read them, understand them. You will know from them what you expect to learn in the end of the course. What are the things that you should be knowing very well and able to differentiate between the various concepts related to software design and software design models. Now, the contents of each of the lectures of the course. First, we are going to take a general overview about system analysis and design. We are going to talk in chapter 1 about the roles of the system analyst or the software engineer. And also in the first lecture, we will talk about the first model, software design model, which is the system development life cycle, or it's called sometimes the software development life cycle. It's the same. So we will talk about this design model and details in the first chapter. We also will talk briefly about the use of case tool, and we will talk about agile approach or agile model also briefly, in addition to a brief introduction to object-oriented method for designing software. All of these will be covered briefly in chapter 1. Next, we are going to take about the life cycle of a project, a software project. So we are going to talk about the requirements of a software, functional and non-functional. We are going to talk about what are the things that we need to know before we can start the process of designing software. So this will be an introduction to the actual design that we will take after that. Now, the first step in the design will be the developing the use case diagrams using the use case modeling tool. We will talk here about use cases in general, what are, and how to develop them, what are the elements, what do they contain, and so on. We will be solving problems related to use cases and use case diagrams and scenarios. Also, we will talk about data flow diagrams. We will have a chapter related to data flow diagrams and their design and implementation. We will have also an assignment on data flow diagrams. Next, we will be talking about UML and object-oriented design of software. So we will talk about the various steps, and if we want to design a software using object-oriented approach, what are the various steps that we want to consider and implement, and what are the different types of diagrams that you must implement in order to design a software using the UML design model. So we will talk about activity diagram, sequence diagram, class diagram. Our aim at the end of the UML is to develop a class diagram for each package of the software. When we implement this class diagram, we will be converting each element in the class diagram into a separate class, and we will be representing the relationships between different classes in the class diagram as relationship between classes, either using inheritance, composition, or calling of functions between classes. After that, we might talk a little bit about the agile model. In the original syllabus here, you see that there is no specific mentioning of the agile model. I prefer to talk about it briefly at the end of the course lectures to make you know about each and every one of the three main models for designing software. So if we have time at the end of the software, at the end of the course, before we need to present a project, we will talk a little bit about in a chapter about the agile design model and its the difference between it and the software development lifecycle and the object-oriented model using UML. This briefly gives you an overview about the content of the course and how the lectures of the course will be divided between the material that we are required to take in the course. So as I told you, on Classroom, you will find everything related to the course. So I have already added the students that have registered so far in the course, and I will add all students that will register from now on also. I have already put the syllabus, the textbook, and the slides of the first chapter on Classroom. Also, I have put an introduction statement for you, which will introduce you to the method of how to use the course and how you will be able to join us in our Zoom meetings that we will do at the time of each lecture of the course because of the situation that we currently have in Lebanon. So this briefly finishes the main introduction of the course. The remaining of this lecture will be a brief overview from chapter 1 of the course about the different type of software systems that exist. Let's take a break, and after that we will continue with the next part of this lecture.